let's take a look at how we can sum values between two dates. We're also going to take a look at how we can sum values for the month, so from the first of the month till the end of the month, and also how to sum with multiple criteria. Here's our sample data set. We have a list of dates here. We have the list of app categories and the revenue generated by these apps. Now, what we want to do is to solve for these. The first problem we have to solve for is we want to sum the revenue that's between these two specific dates that we've defined right here. I'm going to use the SUMIFS formula. SUMIFS is a very easy formula to learn. First argument for it is the sum range. So in this case, that's our revenue. So I'm going to use Control Shift Down to jump to the bottom of the data set. I'm going to press F4 to fix it because I'm planning to pull this formula down and I don't want my referencing to shift. Now the next argument is the criteria range. It's the range where my first criteria is sitting on. Now my first criteria, the actual criteria, is my from date here, but the range where it's sitting on is here. Okay, so make sure you don't mix them up. It's actually the range first and then the actual criteria. So again, I'm going to fix it with the F4 key, and now comes my actual criteria. But is this the actual criteria? So could I just do this? No, right? Because it's looking for this exact date in here. And I don't want this, I want from this date. So this means I need to use the greater than sign here, but check this out. If I press enter, I can't leave the formula. So I do need to treat this like text and put it inside quotation marks. Now again, if I press enter, I can't leave the formula because remember, in Excel formulas, anytime you're combining text with a cell reference, you do need to put in the and sign here. Okay, so now this means I'm getting the revenue for dates that are greater than this, which basically is actually all the dates I have listed here. That's 1126, 428, 1126, 428, because my dates start from the 19th of June. Right, so that's not what I want. I want it to be from this date until this date. Right, so that's where my criteria 2 comes in. But first is the range where it can find my to date. Well, the range is the same, right? So I'm going to highlight that, Control Shift Down, press F4 to fix. And now my actual criteria is this, but what type of sign do I need here? I need the smaller than sign. And if I also want to include this date, so let's say in this case I do want to include it, I can say less than or equal to, put the quotation mark, and pick the date and press enter. So now I have 205,740. That's until the 15th of July, which are these 205,740. Okay, so that looks good. I'm going to send it down. Now let's go on to the next one. We want to sum the revenue for the month. So for the entire June month, July month, we want to sum the revenue. Well, first thing I'm going to do is to put in my months, but check this out. I'm not going to just type the month in. I'm actually going to put a date in there. It's going to be the first of each month. So that's the 1st of June, 2018. Now I'm going to pull this down. Automatically gives me 2nd, 3rd, 4th of June, but I don't want that. So let's click on the fill options and select fill months. So now I get the 1st of July and August and September. So now I don't want it, the user to actually see the first. I want them to see the month and the year. Here I can just format the cells, right? So I can right mouse click format cells or use the shortcut key Control 1. And under date options, let's just scroll down to here where we can see the month and the year. Okay, so that's actually what I want the user to see. Now here for the revenue, I need to take care about the to part, right? Because from part is this, it's just exactly what I had before, but my two part is the end of the month, right? And for this, a great formula comes in handy. I'm just going to type it here. It's called the EOMONTH, end of the month. All it requires is a start date, which in this case is this one, and then how many months I want to count. So I don't want to move any additional months. I want to stay in that same month. So I'm going to put a zero here and press enter. Now let's just update the formatting of this from general. Let's just look at short date just to see what type of dates we get here. And you can see we get the last day of the month here. Right? So that's the formula we can use inside our SUMIFS. The sum range is the same. I'm going to put a 4 to fix it. Criteria range 1, that's our date. Let's fix it. And the criteria 1 is this one, but it's greater than, and in this case, it also equals this cell here. Now, the next one is my criteria range 2, so that's the end of the month. The actual dates, the range is the same, so I'm going to highlight that, press F4 to fix it. And criteria range 2 is this one. So if you have it in helper cells, you can just reference the cells. If you don't have it, you can type the formula in. So start date is this one, and months is 0, close bracket, and is that it? Or did I forget something? I did forget something, right? Because I have greater than or equals to this, and my second criteria is the end of the month. But I don't want the exact end of the month. I want it to be less than or equal to the end of the month. So that should be it. But I need to update my commas here. Let's push this down. Let's just double check. So for September, I have 105, 405. These are September. That's right. So even if we change this to first of the month, and let's also change to the last day of September, you see our number stays the same here, right? So it includes the first and the last day. Just going to press Ctrl Z to go back. And now I can delete these ones here. Let's even add in another criteria. So we want to sum the revenue for the month, but we also want to include the app, right? So for June utility, June productivity, June game, and so on. Now, since I've already done my formula here, I'm going to copy and paste this here. And all I have to do is to add in this additional criteria in the end. So first is the range where the app is sitting on. Press F4 to fix it. That's the actual criteria. Send this down and we have our report. That's how easy it is to use SUMIFS to sum up values between different dates. If you like this video, do give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to this channel, you like what you see, you want to get better in Excel, do consider subscribing.